हेलो एवरीवन, सो आई एम हर्षित, योर ट्रेनर फॉर वेब एप्लीकेशन सिक्योरिटी। सो टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट डीमार्क रिकॉर्ड्स एंड एसपीएफ रिकॉर्ड्स। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द एसपीएफ रिकॉर्ड। सो व्हाट इज़ एन एसपीएफ रिकॉर्ड? सो इन एसपीएफ रिकॉर्ड, द एसपीएफ स्टैंड्स फॉर सेंडर पॉलिसी फ्रेमवर्क, एंड इट इज़ अ टाइप ऑफ रिकॉर्ड विच इज़ maintained by the TNS of the server, the domain name system, which help the email address forgery, which helps to prevent the email address forgery. So what happens in a cybersecurity scenario? Spammers can falsify email headers so it looks like they are sending from an email address at your domain. They can pretend to be you, allowing them to phish your users for private account information, certain types of credentials, their personal information, etc. They can even hijack their email accounts and certain other accounts if they use the correct method for phishing. So what happens if we have an SPF record or any web address or the domain name has its SPF record? So adding an SPF record can help prevent others from spoofing your domain. So now we will see how we can check for the SPF records. So we open the website kitterman.com/spf/validate.html. So in this website you will get a field where you can enter the domain name and click on get SPF record, and you can see the SPF record has been found, and it says the result of this test was soft fail. What does this mean? This means that the SPF is available but somehow it failed to validate the SPF records. So let's go back and check for jrsecurity.ins domain, and we can see that in this case the SPF record passed validation test with PySPF, that is Python SPF library. So we have a correct SPF record, but that domain has not any correct SPF records. Okay, so now here is the way you can check for SPF records. Now let's come to DMARC records. So what basically is a DMARC record? A DMARC record is the core of a DMARC implementation in which DMARC record rule sets are defined. This DMARC record informs email receivers that if a domain is set up for DMARC. If so, the DMARC record contains the policy which the domain owner wants to use. In essence, DMARC record a DNS entry. So a DMARC record does actually is, this DMARC record informs the email receivers or the clients, you can say, or the receivers of the email, that if any domain with that name is set up for DMARC or not. So how we can check for the DMARC records of any website is like, we can go through dmarcanalyzer.com/dmarc/dmarc-record-check, and here we can enter the domain name to check for the DMARC records. Let's click on I am not a robot, and I obviously am not, and click on validate DNS. So when I click on this record, I can see that we could not find a DMARC record. So this domain is not at all secured, and anyone can phish this organization's email address to see that if the DMARC, if they can phish any users of this organization, they can send false or forged emails to get the credentials and other personal information of the users. So thank you for this lesson. We will meet in our next lesson. Bye bye, take care.